Hey guys, Carissa Rose here. So in this video today, I'm going to be doing something a little bit differently than what I normally do. Don't worry, I'm not stopping doing art videos. I just changed my hair recently and I thought it would be cool to record the process for y'all. Can't believe I just said y'all. Anyways, so the first thing I did was I bleached the blue out of my bangs and bleached the sides of my hair. And then now I'm going in with some Pravana Vivids Neon Green hair dye for my bangs. And I'm going to be doing leopard print on the sides. So I've done leopard print on my sides quite a few times in the past. So I have gotten pretty good at doing it myself. I normally just use a paintbrush and some black hair dye and paint it right on there. The difficult part, as you can imagine, is normally when I get to the back of my head. On the right side, it's not so bad. It'd be easier if I had a better handheld mirror, but I kept forgetting to pick one up. They seem to always break on me. So the harder part is doing the left side, because I can only go so far with my right hand before I can't reach or see. So when I start doing the back, I'm actually using my left hand, so that was a bit of a challenge, but I'm still pretty happy with the results, and I'm right-handed, clearly. So I did all the black with a semi-permanent blue-black dye. I'm not sure what the brand was, I can't remember, and then I went with the neon green inside of it. Luckily, it all came out okay. I was worried that the green and black would blend together because I did them at the same time, but it seemed to work pretty well. So here it is all dry after washing it out. I left it in for like 25 minutes before I washed it out. So what I'm doing here is separating all my hair into even pieces as evenly as I could. I had 30 double-ended dreads that I was trying to install. So I tried to do 6 rows of 5 separated pieces to fit all the dreads in. This is my 3rd time installing synthetic dreads. The first time my sister helped me with it, and then I did it once myself before. I kind of have the hang of it now. So these synthetic dreads I actually made. Basically, I got a bunch of bags of kanekalon hair. It's like a plasticky wig-like hair. It comes in bags in a big braid. And then with one bag of the kanekalon hair, you can normally make anywhere between like 5 to 10 dreads, depending on how thin you make them. I normally ended up getting around 6 dreads per bag. There's a bunch of really great tutorials on YouTube for how to make the synthetic dreads, and that's how I learned to make them. So I definitely suggest searching around YouTube if you're interested in making your own set. I have to say, it's not easy and it's very time consuming. So if you are willing to spend the extra money to get a professional set made by someone who really knows what they're doing, it's worth the cost. But I like to DIY it, so I normally end up doing things myself. That's how I went about it. But basically, you just have to get the kanekalon here. Kanekalon, such a weird word. Kanekalon here. And you tease the crap out of it, and then you have to twist it and steam it. I didn't have a steamer, so I used a straightener and a wet rag. And it took me many, many hours to make these. But in the end, I'm super happy with them. I've always wanted long hair, and for whatever reason, my hair just does not want to grow long. So having these dread extensions in is a really great solution for me, and I really like the style of them. As far as installing them goes, also very time consuming. And if you do it yourself, your arms are going to be so tired. You can tell as the video proceeds, I hold my arms lower and lower as it goes on because they were just tired as hell. I think it took me around 4 hours total to install all of them. On a side note, you can see occasionally throughout the video, I'm smoking a pen. It is a vapor pen. I recently quit smoking cigarettes, which is a big win for me after 8 years of smoking. I do still smoke the e-cigarettes, but it is a step up health-wise, so I'm gonna continue to try to do that. anyways, putting the dreads in, as far as like the weight goes, since they're like really evenly distributed, they're not super heavy. They're pretty comfortable actually for me. I mean, other people might not agree, so I guess it depends on the person. If you're interested in getting synthetic dreads for yourself, I'd say definitely do some research and make sure they're right for you. And remember, it's really trial and error. This is my third time putting them in, but it's my first time that I really like how they came out. And it's the second set I made, so it definitely takes some practice, but it's, you get the hang of it, and it can look really, really cool and be a pretty quick way to have your hair styled nicely. And by quick, I mean after it's all done. You don't really have to do much to style it to make it look cool. So here is the full set all in, and yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it. So I'm going to be doing a lot more videos to come. Definitely more art videos. I don't know if I'll do more hair videos. If you liked it, let me know in the comments. And yeah, I guess that is all for now. So, see you guys soon. Grissa Rose signing off. Toodles.